you know, I got lots of white fans, lots of black fans that come to my shows, Puerto Ricans, Jews, it doesn't matter. I'm here to please all. Yeah. The color makes no difference, you know.
So it didn't upset you? Do you ever think you were, like, again, reverse racism, that they kind of held you back because you weren't black in the business?
Well, you know, like I said, a lot of people told me, you know, there's never going to be a white rapper. There's not going to be like that. Because, I was rapping way before the Beastie Boys, you know, ever came out. And I was getting it back then. And you know, I don't let what somebody tells me
influence.
Bother or influence me.
Now, let me get the good stuff here. What do they call you, Vinay or Ice?
No.
What do they call you for sure?
Call me Ice.
How'd you get the name Vanilla Ice?
Well, it was just Vanilla. It started off, just like any nickname really would. About when I was 13. And then, you know, I started rapping and getting into that. And then the Ice came along. And then people just started calling me Ice. Now, my mother even calls me Ice.
What about when you and Madonna left the American... was the American Music Awards? What happened? You can tell me. Think of me as a dear, sweet aunt that only wants your best. What happened?
You can keep it a secret, right?
Who am I going to tell? We're a little show.
Oh, okay.
Everyone here has sworn to secrecy.
Ask her.
Oh, really? Well, she'll say you did everything. You know about Madonna.
I don't know.
Madonna, well, you know that. Madonna is the Geraldo of rap music. I mean, that's no question. Yes. What happened? Did you have a romance?
Ask her. No.
No?
I don't know. Ask her.
All right. Are you romantic? Are you involved with anybody now?
We're Phoebe.
Involved? You know, somebody had that queued up. They had that one queued up. Somebody had to say that one.
Phoebe is...
You told her to say that. How much you pay her to say that?
Who said it? I don't even know who those people are.
Sure.
No.
Uh-huh.
I wouldn't do that. Phoebe was a girl you took out, and you had a nice evening
Phoebe
with her.
Phoebe is great. Where's she at? She's
Where's Phoebe?
Great.
We should just show
she's
Phoebe.
She's
on. Where's Phoebe? Phoebe, hello, Phoebe. You're allowed. She's single. You're single. You're allowed to take out lots of girls. Are you going with anybody special now?
No, I mean, you know, I'm in a different country every day.
What about films? Now, they're comparing you, which is very heady, I would think, to Elvis Presley. That, you know, you're going to switch over into films. Do you want to do that? Or you want to do both? Or where do you want to be in 10 years?
Well, I'll tell you, you know, the movies are great. The movies are cool. And, you know, they pay a lot of money. I got to admit that. But, like I said, I'm not in it for the money. My heart is into rap music. You know, I got 7 songs that I've almost got completed for my 4th album. Which is after the soundtrack album.
Right, which is what we're doing now here.
Yeah,
Cool
we're doing soundtrack now, but which is actually like my second album, because the second album was, you know, a live album, which was To the Extreme, you know, with a couple new tracks done live, and then the soundtrack. So this 4th album is going to be like my second real album to the Extreme. And, you know, a lot of people have disrespected me this year and stuff, you know, talking this and talking that. But, you know, this new stuff has got to be harder than hard, fresher than fresh, iller than ill, doper than dope. I mean, just, you know, the real stuff to get the respect back. You know what I'm saying?
So do you work every day? Do you go into a room, lock yourself away? Because people see you now, they see you cute, fun.
I'm always locked away. Huh?
Yeah. But do you say, every day do you write? How do you do it?
I do it, I'm in a different country. I just got off a world tour. I just came back from London, England, Germany, France, Japan, Asia, Australia, Brazil, Mexico, you know, and I'm in a different country every single day. I get locked up in a room all the time.
Yeah. Does it blow your head?
No, I just get in the room and I sit down with my 1200 drum machine and whatever, my Kai 950s, you know, and I got a little portable studio. Come up with some new stuff, you know?
Yeah. No, I don't mean that. I mean that you can go to Japan and they know you in Japan. Doesn't that just get you crazy? Because I know when I walk down a street in England and they know me, it still goes to me, wow, it's so wonderful. Do you understand how fabulous that is, you know?
Yes, great.
Isn't that good?
Cool.
What's your biggest...
But, everybody, it seems like, you know, he gets all this pleasure, all these places. Wow, big vacation. He's got it made, you know, but it ain't like that.
Yeah.
Because I see the same thing I see every single night. Like I said, I'm locked up all the time. I see a hotel room, a limousine, and a stage. Next city, hotel, limo, stage. Next city, hotel, limo, stage.
Can you stop them? Can you say to them, I want to take a break? Have you had a chance to say, give me 3 weeks to disappear?
I've said it. No one listens to me. You got to be here, Ice. I need you here, man.
Yeah, yeah.
All right. Let's go.
What's your biggest extravagance?
Extravagance.
I know you took care of your mother very well and your family, which is lovely.
Well, you know, what family I have. I love my mother. You know, like I said, I'm not real close to her. I mean, I take care of her.
Yeah.
You know, bought her house, bought her car.
What about you? What have you just said? Oh, I'm just going to get this. What have you done for yourself? Gotta do something nice.
Well, I haven't had any time to do anything.
And you know,
I've been on tour for the last 2 years. I really...
Motorcycle?
I bought a car, I bought a couple houses, I bought a couple cars.
Well, so life's not tragic.
I ain't never had no money. Yeah. I bought everything. I spent it all. I'm broke now.
All right, well then...
So dial 1-900-ICE-BABY and give me some money. No, it ain't like that.
Well, will you hang out now? Because Lisa's coming up. Lisa will be here in a second with Cult Jam. And we're going to listen to them, and then we're going to talk to them, okay? So, will you stick around?
Sure.
Terrific. We'll be right back with Lisa, Cult Jam, and Vanilla Ice.
Chance I don't believe you. Well, I may not have been the best. I tried so hard to communicate. Why couldn't I talk to you? Now it's too late. Where were you when I needed you? Did you get yourself lost in a chance to. I heard you sing somebody your love song. I pray to God I heard wrong. When I needed tender love and care, you were never there, never, never there. When I needed you, did you get yourself lost in another? Get yourself lost in another girl's arms. Where were you?
right. Let me ask you. First of all, the three of you now, I keep saying Lisa, and Cult Jam, right? But you're really like one package.
Yeah.
Oh,
how
yeah.
how
oh, yeah.
long are you together?
7 years. Hmm.
Seven and a half.
How'd you meet?
We met at some clubs in New York. Our producers and managers, Full Force, were looking for a group to do the song they did, I Wonder If I Take You Home. And I met Lisa in a club and met him at some parties. And we all got together and made magic.
Now, how do you get together when you go for a new album? Who decides what's going to go on the album?
Well, basically, we do.
Yeah.
We get together with our production manager and managers, and we figure out what the concept of the album is going to be, what we want to do, how we're going to get down and jam. So, I mean, it's just the whole one thing.
Is it vote? Is it Democratic? 2-1?
Yeah. Everybody puts everything in there. You know. Everything.
Big fights or never fight?
Some.
Always
fights. I mean, it's a big family, you know. Our managers, six of them, and seven, actually counting Steve, and three of us, and... I mean, it's a whole big organization, so we all stay together like family.
Dogs, cats.
Sir.
Well, I hope you stay together long. You're just wonderful. Congratulations. It's just terrific.
Thank you.
And we'll be back with more tomorrow. Will you come over and talk a little bit?
Oh, yeah,
so we'll
please.
Find out what happened to you. You lost a lot of weight. You look great. Okay, we'll be right back with more in a moment with Lisa, so stay with us. That's it. Thank you. Charts and Vanilla Ice, his new movie, Cool as Ice, comes out tomorrow. And you've lost a lot of weight since you were here.
Mm.
On purpose or just the road?
Well, both. On purpose and the road. I mean, being on stage twice a night, 7 nights a week, for about 6 to 9 months out of the year, yes, definitely, you lose weight.
Yeah. See, Ice was just talking about that. It's very tough. People think it's so glamorous. Are you going out with anybody?
Me?
Yeah.
Yes.
Great. All right. Is that where you got the ring from?
No, these are just friendship rings.
That's some
gifts,
friendship.
Friends.
That's a very, yeah.
That's a, no. I'm getting into that personal thing. I was married and now I'm divorced, and I went through it all, and it was hard. It was, I mean, trying to be on the road and get your work together and your life and your career together and have your family, you know, at the same time. It takes a lot of work. It really does. It takes a lot of work, and I guess my other half at the time had nothing to do with the music business at all.
That's
and
very tough.
They couldn't get, he, you know, just couldn't deal with it, which is okay. Peace to you, brother, but I'm happy now, so.
And what
Oh, yeah. And Cracker Jack prizes are only going to get bigger.
There you go. Cracker Jack prizes.
Now, what about extravagance? We were just talking, you know, and we were talking about the first thing that Ice bought, like car, you know, and stuff like that. What did you go crazy when the first time you got the money? What did you do for yourself?
I didn't do anything, actually. Well, the first big money I received, I went home and I took my family out to a very big dinner, and I was just happy. I was only 17 years old. I was very happy to be able to pay the check myself.
Yeah, that's.
And I was happy to be just slipping money to. Okay, everybody, take a cab home.
Yeah.
Yeah, take a cab home.
Yeah.
But I mean, I have my own house. I have an apartment in the city, you know, too, and I had a car, crashed it. But I mean, I'm happy. I'm very happy. I have my own studio now.
Do you still live in the old neighborhood for a while? You stay in your old neighborhood?
Yeah. Yeah, I'm still there. I have my own house upstate, but I'm always in the city. I mean, Hell's Kitchen is a thing for me. Huh? Born and raised in Hell's Kitchen.
Matt, you are the youngest of 10.
Yes.
And are you the most successful?
Well, I think so. I shouldn't say that. I feel so conceited saying that. No, but yeah, I think I am the most known.
Yeah. But what are some of the others doing?
I have a niece who's a singer, actress, dancer, right. And she just got one of the lead parts in the new Malcolm X movie. So, her name is Monique. I love you, baby.
Okay, that's awesome.
My nephew, he's very young. He's 14 years old, and he's doing some episodes with The Cosby Show, so, and he's done commercials and things.
It's a theatrical.
Yeah, and I have an older sister who I looked up to, who is a trained opera singer.
Oh, so it's...
She's a school teacher now, though, because she couldn't take it.
You should put her on one of the albums.
I should.
Yeah, it would be great.
And my brother Raymond, who used to... he tours with me now. Raymond, he used to play with a lot of Latin bands.
So it's all... They're all
in
business.
Music.
Now, will you stay? We have two of the biggest disc jockeys in New York coming on now from Z100. Will you guys stick around?
Or
if you're very good, maybe they'll play your albums tomorrow.
I need to speak to
them. Do you still have to call disc jockeys and beg? We'll find out when we come back. We will meet two men who have the power to either make or break of any music artist.
That's
so we'll be right back. That is the truth. Okay. We'll be right back.
Thank you.